హలో హాయ్ మై డియర్ స్టూడెంట్ ఫ్రెండ్స్, వెల్కమ్ టు మై ఛానల్ హెచ్ఎస్ఆర్ బయో ఇన్ఫో. టుడే వి ఆర్ గోయింగ్ టు కంటిన్యూ ది హ్యూమన్ డైజెస్టివ్ సిస్టమ్. ఇన్ ప్రీవియస్ సెషన్ వి హావ్ స్టడీడ్ ది హౌ హ్యూమన్ డైజెస్టివ్ సిస్టమ్ ఎక్విప్డ్ విత్ ది టీత్ అరేంజ్మెంట్ ఇన్ ద మౌత్. అండ్ ఇన్ దిస్ క్లాస్ వి ఆర్ గోయింగ్ టు సీ ది సలైవరీ గ్లాండ్స్. So, what are the salivary glands? Salivary glands are the glands which are secrete the saliva into the mouth. Saliva into the mouth. So, actually where salivary glands are present, we will see here. We know very well, this is the mouth. In this mouth, this part is called as empty space, we calling buccal cavity. This is the upper lip, lower lip, and here there is a odd cartilage tissue that is we are called palate. This palate that ends it here, there is a nasal region and also in this way human digestive system is equipped. So here is the buccal cavity. In the buccal cavity there is a tongue. There is a tongue. Beneath the tongue, there is a two glands. See, this is the human mouth. Here is the mouth part. Beneath the tongue, this red part is the tongue. There is a two glands. These two glands, along with these two glands, there is also one more gland here. So see, there is three types of salivary glands which are present in the mouth region. So anterior part of the mouth, posterior part of the mouth. In the posterior part there is a one salivary gland that opens into the mouth, and upper part and lower part of the mouth. In the lower part beneath the tongue there is a gland that is called a salivary gland. That salivary glands also secretes the saliva into the mouth. This gland again connect with the one more salivary glands. That salivary gland secrete the saliva into this one. This again secrete the saliva into the mouth. So let us see what these glands are calling. See, I already mentioned this in the previous classes. This is called as parotid gland. This is called parotid gland, one of the salivary gland. This gland we are calling sublingual gland. Sublingual gland, and also this we are called submandibular gland. Submandibular gland, why we are calling submandibular gland is, see, there is a bone beneath the bone. This bone is called mandibular bone. So beneath the mandibular bone, there is a gland. That's why it is called as a submandibular bone. Submandibular gland. And also beneath the tongue, that's why it is calling the sublingual gland. At the posterior part, we are calling parotid gland. All these parotid gland and sublingual gland and submandibular gland. These glands secrete the saliva. Saliva, actually it is a fluid. This fluid contains the 98% water. Rest of the thing which includes the bicarbonates, electrolytes and also enzyme. Actually here the enzyme is a tylin. Right now we are calling amylase. Tylin is a previous name. Right now we are calling amylase enzyme. So what we have to remember is the enzyme which is present in the saliva is the amylase. This amylase is very essential for the digestion of the carbohydrates. We will see how amylase digests the carbohydrates in the upcoming classes. So in this way, salivary glands which are present at the mouth part, they are secreting the saliva into the mouth. They containing the electrolytes and enzymes and 98% of water and also some mucus. It contains the some mucus, a jelly like structure. So along with these, saliva is made, and this type of saliva secreted into the mouth. This saliva mixed with the food what we are intaken and forms the bolus. I already mentioned the what is the bolus. This bolus that enter from mouth to the buccal cavity, buccal cavity to the what? Pharynx. Buccal cavity to the pharynx. Okay, it is clear, I think. So let us start pharynx. So see where actually pharynx is present. Pharynx is a buccal cavity that open into the pharynx. Actually, pharynx is the empty space which is a mediator for the both air and food particles. So see, actually pharynx again divided into the three regions. Pharynx divided into the three regions. One is a nasopharyngeal pharynx. Second one is the oropharyngeal pharynx. Third one is the laropharyngeal pharynx. So nasopharyngeal pharynx and oropharyngeal pharynx and laropharyngeal pharynx. See where actually these pharynx are present. Here this entire part is the nasal region. This nasal region essential for the taking air from the nasal. So here actually see pharynx is occupied from here to here. In this pharynx, the occupancy of the air, that type of pharynx from here to here, which is called as nasopharyngeal. In the only the mouth part that open into the pharynx, this region, this is called oropharyngeal. And beneath the oropharyngeal and In this entire part we are called laryngeal pharynx. Laryngeal pharynx. So in this way, pharynx can be divided into the three types: naso, oro, laro. Simply we have to remember, naso means nasal region part of the pharynx, oro means oral part of the pharynx, laro means larynx part of the pharynx. Actually, see, the pharynx here, laryngeal pharynx, that connected with the larynx, connected with the larynx, and also connected with the esophagus, and also connected with the esophagus. See, larynx is the site where after larynx there is trachea is started. So larynx that contains the an opening that is called as a glottis. From the glottis, larynx that open into the laryngeal region. And also here, see, this is called as epiglottis. This epiglottis prevents the entry of food particle into the trachea through the larynx. Actually, we discussed this function of epiglottis in previous session. So see, esophagus also open into the laryngeal region. From esophagus and also larynx, both regions are connected with the laryngeal regions. So see, what actually happening, the food particle what we are intaking, they are coming here and they are go in this way. They are go in this way due to presence of the epiglottis, and also this epiglottis prevents the entry of food particle into the trachea. So what we have next part here, that is called esophagus. That is called esophagus. Okay, let us start esophagus. How esophagus is present? See, we are looking every part of the alimentary canal, start with the mouth, and we completed the pharynx. Right now we are seeing the esophagus. Esophagus. Actually, see how esophagus is present. How esophagus is present, and esophagus starts at the laryngeal region, and that extend posteriorly into the very long region, and it's cross the thorax region, and also diaphragm. Finally, it enter into the or open into the stomach. So esophagus extended posteriorly into the thorax region, and also it crosses the diaphragm, and finally it enter into the stomach. This is called as esophagus. Esophagus looking like this. Okay, see, actually esophagus that open into the stomach through the sphincter that is called as cardiac sphincter. Cardiac sphincter. Esophagus open into the sphincter that is called as the cardiac sphincter. Cardiac sphincter is essential for the esophagus opening and also closing system. So it regulates the closing and opening mechanism of the esophagus, that is into the stomach region. So let us see how esophagus is present, how esophagus internal structure is present. Not a esophagus, all elementary canal is present. We will see how they are looking like. So, see, this esophagus or elementary canal system contains the outer layer. I am drawing this region. If you assume this region, if you section that part, that looks like this. Outer side, they are looking a cell layer. That cell layer called serosa cells. Serosa cells. So, beneath the serosa cells, there is called striated muscle layer. There is a striated muscle layer. Striated muscle layer. Beneath this striated muscle layer, there is a one more layer that is called as circular layer. This region, entire red region. Circular muscle layer. In the middle part of the gut or elementary canal that contains the many foldings. These many foldings are looking like this. So, these foldings are lined with the epithelial cells. These foldings lined internally with the epithelial cells. This green part, epithelial cells. And these are the foldings. These foldings are very essential for secretion of the mucus into the elementary canal. Secretion of mucus into the elementary canal due to the presence of the secretory glands, they are calling mucus glands. These foldings that contains the some mucus glands. So these mucus glands secretes the mucus into the elementary canal. That elementary canal contains the food mixed with the mucus of the elementary gut or elementary canal. Let us see, this part is also go in depth or deep foldings. These deep foldings we are calling submucosal. Submucosal glands. So, in this way, elementary canal or elementary gut is present in this manner. So, outer cell layer is the serosa cells. Next to striated muscle layer, circular muscle layer and mucus secreting layer that contains the mucus glands and also contains the submucosal glands. And finally, in the internal part that is lined with the epithelial cells. So, in this way, human digestive system that contains the elementary canal, that elementary canal if we cut into the section that looking like this. Okay. So, see actually what esophagus is doing in the digestion process. Esophagus function of esophagus. Actually, esophagus is straight pipe-like structure. The food that enter from here to the here, what actually the food that enter from esophagus to the stomach? Let us see, it is a tube-like structure that contains here the food. This food must be go into this area, finally reach to the stomach. Then what happened? Actually, the food going in this way, but it is not go very easily because of the cell lining or muscle lining of the esophagus that influence or stimulates the movement of the food particle forward into the stomach. Through the process we are calling peristalsis. Peristalsis. So, due to the peristalsis movements of the elementary canal or the esophagus, the food particles that move forward into the stomach region. Then what is the peristalsis? You can see the circular muscles. The circular muscles which are present in the gut, they are the contract. They are the contrast. For example, this is the 0 second. Here, the food particle need to be go forward. Then what happening, circular muscles which are present in the gut that are that forms a some contraction here. At the 0 second, the food particle here, after a 5 seconds, after a 5 seconds, see the food particle are bolus. After 5 seconds, the food particle moved from here to the ear only due to the contraction of the circular muscles. This contraction we are calling the peristalsis. And this peristalsis contraction leads to the movement of the food particle to forward into the stomach. That's why it is calling the peristalsis movement. Peristalsis movement. So, in this way, how food is enter through the mouth and from where to the buccal cavity, mixed with the salivary glands. Salivary glands secreted saliva and converted into the bolus. Bolus enter into the pharynx, pharynx to the esophagus. Here esophagus causes the peristaltic movements. This peristaltic movement leads to the movement of the food particle into the stomach. So this is the today's session. In tomorrow our upcoming classes, I will discuss the stomach in detail manner, how stomach secretes the different kinds of the enzymes and different kinds of the acids into the lumen of the stomach, and how they mix into the food particles, and how they essential for the conversion of food particle into the very small pieces. I hope you people understand this class is very well. So if you like this class and lecture, please do subscribe my channel HSR Bioinfo, and don't forget to subscribe it. If you not subscribed it, please like, share, comment.